In order to efficiently examine our community, we first had to identify what major infrastructure make up a community. We narrowed it down to four components that we decided to research, which were community members, shared government, common cultural and historical heritage, and local businesses. We visited our local pharmacy and talked to the employees about what technology they use in their store on a daily basis, and all they could think of was the cash register. It didn't dawn on them that machines like theft sensors, surveillance cameras, copy machines, photo stations, and much more technology was around them. We visited 17 businesses in our area, and only 9 had positions with people with a STEM background. We also visited 10 schools, and only 2 of them had STEM programs. After looking at our research, we came to the conclusion that we would have to involve our state government. So we visited the state's capital. We were unable to talk to the governor directly, but we got a chance to talk to the local press about our concerns on this matter. On a local level, we also went to the police station to discuss what technologies were being used and also what programs were available to the public. Unfortunately, there were none available for people like myself. We will meet with schools that have STEM programs and then go to the schools that do not have the programs and prepare them to come out to our STEM Awareness Robotics Competition. Our action plan is simple. We would like to implement an annual robotics competition hosted at our own school campus where we will invite local schools to compete. During the event, we will have learning and training stations that will serve as the bridge for those underexposed to these technologies and start a foundation for the community to be immersed in the world of STEM technology.